friends, today we'll look at green coffee. Many of you have heard about green tea, but you would not have heard about green coffee. Green coffee is an extract from the coffee bean. It's called the green coffee bean extract. Before we go to the potential benefits of green coffee, I'll explain what happens in a human cell. There are a lot of metabolic processes happening in the human cell all over the body every second. Here, these metabolic processes generate what are called reactive oxygen species. So, they have a damaging property. They can go and attach themselves to the electron transport system, to the mitochondria, to the Golgi apparatus, and can damage a lot of intracellular structures. So, every second, antioxidants are also generated by the body, which go and fight these bad elements and neutralize them. So sometimes the body's ability to supply antioxidants goes down, then the disease takes over. We get a lot of antioxidants from natural food sources. A lot of vegetables and fruits can all provide antioxidants. This green coffee bean extract has got what is called chlorogenic acid. The chlorogenic acid is a fantastic antioxidant. But what happens is the regular coffee bean has to be roasted to be made into a regular coffee powder. So this process of roasting completely destroys the chlorogenic acid. So it has only caffeine and other polyols which are found in coffee. Whereas the coffee beans, the green coffee beans, without undergoing the process of roasting, they can be taken to minus 20 deep freeze, and then they have to be powdered, pulverized using the machines. Then that gives a green coffee bean extract. The green coffee bean extract has been found to provide a great rich source of chlorogenic acid. The caffeine content may be equal in the green coffee bean extract when compared to the regular roasted coffee bean extract. But then there are processes for decaffeination so that the caffeine levels are reduced. So the green coffee bean extract which we use has got only 15 milligrams of caffeine per sachet, whereas 350 milligrams of the chlorogenic acid along with vitamin A, C, E, another 150 milligrams, so that about 500 milligrams of antioxidant values available in each sachet that we use. It is also like a drink. It has got a strawberry hibiscus flavor. So it is a very good drink that it can be mixed with hot water or cold water, just 100 ml and drunk. So it immediately increases the serotonin in the brain and boosts your mood. So it's a great antidepressant. But apart from that, the chlorogenic acid has got fantastic properties. There have been beautiful trials in the animals, but also in the human beings of late. There was a beautiful article published in the Journal of Pharmaceutical Sciences and Research in 2018, where they took 35 obese people, 24 were females, 11 were males. They were given 1000 milligrams of green coffee bean extract per day for 6 weeks, and they followed up various parameters. What are the parameters followed up? The body mass index was the primary one. From 36 BMI, it came down to 34. The cholesterol values came down from 157 to 138. The HDL cholesterol went up from 34 to 40. The LDL cholesterol, which was 90 plus, came down to 60. The VLDL came down. The triglycerides also, from 157, it came down to 140. The fasting blood glucose, which was 90 plus, came down to 80. These were all beautiful parameters. They were published scientifically today. And it shows that the green coffee bean extract does work in controlling a lot of parameters, the metabolic parameters. So, and it'll be a great help. And it has no big side effects. And it's very safe to take. So, I would recommend green coffee for obese people. Even systemic hypertension comes down. In my own patients, we have followed up for 6 years. The BMI comes down. the diabetes comes down, the systemic hypertension comes down, then dyslipidemia also improves. So it's a great help to take green coffee. Next time, if you think of green tea, please choose green coffee. It'll give more benefits than green tea, which has got phenolic compounds which are much weaker than the chlorogenic acid.